We have the privilege to talk to you from the Dattatappavan, which is Raja Yogi Mohanji's ashram in the making. It's a place that is indescribably peaceful, without any unnatural sounds or interference. And Mohanji has generously consented to answer some of our most pressing questions. And we are at his feet for this incredible privilege.
Mohanji, can you talk to us about religion and if there's a difference between religion and spirituality, and clarify that for us?
Religion actually started with man. Religion is part of man. So, what is the religion of God? Have you ever thought? The God is the same, but perceptions are different. When you have, like, each individual has a constitution inherent, and it's exclusive to himself or herself. So in such a situation, everybody cannot understand everybody. Everybody will not follow every guru. There will be preferences. There will be choices, individual choices, where people can appreciate a certain path, certain God, certain religion. So religions are formed as part of the quest of man to find God, or to find himself rather. You know, to find himself and then to find God. So the question has been, who am I? So it took the person, took the individual, took the mankind in search of certain awareness, and it took them through such paths. And then eventually they became religions. So there has been prophets, there has been saints who went beyond the box and identified certain aspects of themselves, and then they formulated certain system so that people can understand or appreciate themselves or understand themselves in whichever level, and then from there they can understand God. So religion would be more or less like a pattern or a particular agenda or a particular method through which you can explore God. Or explore yourself. First explore yourself and explore God. And religion have various aspects, such as it caters to a person who is of an intellectual nature. They wanted to know everything in the intellectual plane. And only then they can understand God, or they will accept God. Some people are emotional by nature. They want devotion as the means to reach God. So this is catered as well. And some people like to serve people. They are good hearted. And they like to serve people, and through the service they find themselves and they find God. So every religion is a concoction, is a mixture of all these aspects, you know. And then some of the people will explore further. They go beyond. They go beyond to the level where, fine, I have all these rituals. I have done all these and I haven't been quite satisfied. I should actually experience God. These are the people who get filtered from the usual path of the religions, and they grow higher. That would be a very few. Because usually people get stuck with the rituals, and they feel that through the rituals, if they don't do the rituals, or if they are away from the rituals, there is some problem. So man created religions, and man created the aspects of God in forms which they can understand or relate to. You cannot relate to something which is alien to you. If I give you a food which you have never tasted before, you may taste it, but you may not appreciate it, or you may not accept it. Likewise, every person has a constitution, and according to the constitution only, they can appreciate something. So a person who has no inclination towards alcohol, even if you give the best alcohol, this is of no use. It is of no use for him. Likewise, so there are various types of religions, so that the various types of people are catered to. And some religions instill a lot of fear, and some, and mostly, I mean, you can see today, people are bound to religions because of fear, many times. That's not the right path, because actually God should be fearlessness. You should love God, not fear God. So fearing God is basically a kind of compulsive or degenerated kind of worship. It's a degenerated kind of worship. Because if you love God and be God, you understand God. If you fear God, God is outside of you and something which you are afraid of. And that fear makes you work. That means you are a slave. That is anti-liberation. You cannot be liberated when you are a slave, because you accepted the slavery. You don't accept liberation. So if God is an entity which is kindness, which is love, and you be that, and when you become one with that constitution of God, you merge with God, there is no you anymore. This is the way towards the path of liberation. That means you and God are one. There is nothing to worship outside of you, because you became part of the constitution, which is God, or which is the past, became part of the larger awareness, which is God. So from your limited awareness of a limited entity to the unlimited awareness of God, it's a transition. So as you transcend this, you actually feel God. You feel love. You feel the reality, the truth. So all the religions are based on one truth, but the paths are different because it caters to different sets of people. So I can never say something is good or something is bad. It's relative. For some people, some is suitable. For some people, some food is good for somebody and it's poison for another, right? So it's like that. So we can't say which religion is good or bad, but it's created by man. This is part of the exploration of man, or the quest to know who is he and what is God. So this is how all the religions are formed, and they continue. And whatever is not adaptable to the changes of the situation, because life changes all the time, they die off. Something which cannot endure the time, they go. Because all these philosophies are nice, they are good, because they have been given by people who are enlightened. This has been delivered by people, prophets or guides, who have seen God. You know, all these scriptures, all the various guiding books or guiding principles that we learn on in every day, have been delivered by people of great depth, big people, big in the sense, in spiritual level, highly enlightened. And they have always tried to deliver whatever is good for mankind. But understand one thing. They have all been addressing a particular set of people who were their contemporaries. So they use the kind of language, they use the kind of ideas or things that they can understand, and probably kept rules and regulations which are suitable for their community or that particular society which they were moving in. Adaptability is required. As the time grows, you have to adapt to new situations, new set of people, evolved set of people, and bring them up higher. So often what happens is interpretations becomes a problem. People do interpret, that is, coming generations have to interpret whatever the predecessors have said and cater to the new set of people. But often what happens is the person who interprets may not be of the level of enlightenment of the creator, the one who created us first. So distortions happen in religion. So when distortions happen in the message, calamities happen. Because the what is originally understood, when it is delivered, becomes a different subject. That can create alienation, that can create anarchy. This is a problem. So everyone need to explore themselves individually, not follow like one cow follows another. That's not a good idea, because then you are closing your mind. Some people say my guru is the best guru, everyone else is bad. This is not true. Everyone has their guru, everyone has their God, everyone has their religion. Everything is good for them. That may not be good for us, but it's okay, because there are 7 billion people in the world, 7 billion unique combinations. So when we have all these people and all these constitutions to work with, every religion should be adaptable to everyone, because each you can't give one medicine for all diseases. You know, a general tonic cannot cure; it can probably keep you well. So you have to find your concoction that cures you. This is an individual responsibility. We miss this always because we follow the crowd. I hope I have explained the religion and its traits.
Yes, clarity. Thank you, Mohanji.
If God is an entity which is kindness, which is love, and you be that, and when you become one with that constitution of God, you merge with God, there is no you anymore. This is the way towards the path of liberation. That means you and God are one. There is nothing to worship outside of you because you became part of the constitution, which is God.